Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I make the fire glasses filters, and those filters look like this. So if you want to learn how to make those filters, make sure to stick around for the video. Also, this is a change of scenery, and I don't know if this is going to be my permanent filming spot or not, but if it is, I will definitely be fixing it because it does not look the best. But I just wanted a better setup, so this is much better than what it was before. Before we get started, don't forget to follow me on all my social media, my Instagram, Snapchat, and TikTok. And also don't forget to use my Snapchat lenses. You can just search up Christian Roberts in Snapchat and they will all pop up. And also don't forget to use my Instagram filters. You can go to Instagram, click the filter button on my profile, and all my lenses will be right there. But yeah, also don't mind the way I look. Just don't mind it. And since you clicked on this video, you might as well subscribe and also click the bell so you get notified every time I post a brand new video. But yeah, I don't want to hold y'all for too long, so let's just get right on into the video. Okay guys, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to have to download the Fire Glasses PNG. And what we are going to need to do for that is we're going to go to Safari, and then we're going to search up Fire Glasses. And then go to Images, and this is the one that I used. So you're just going to want to download this onto your computer. So then once you have the image downloaded, you're going to open it up, and this is what it looks like. You're going to go to this little pen tool right here and then click this. This is Instant Alpha. And then you're going to click on the white in the background and drag it. And make sure you don't drag it to where the red from it is on the actual glasses itself. You just want it on the white so that you can press delete. And then the white from the background will be taken off. And then you're just gonna wanna do that for right here, right here, right here, and right here. So now you are left with the fire glasses. And then to get rid of the little metal pieces that hold the glasses onto your head, we're just going to go up here and click the arrow and go to lasso selection. So what we're going to want to do is take the little lasso selector and hold down with one finger on the trackpad and then scroll with the other finger. And we're going to want to just go right on the outline of the fire glasses and then go to the other side right here and then just circle that and then press delete. And that gets rid of whatever like selection you select around it. So I got rid of that metal, and then do that to the other side as well. And obviously you're gonna do this like better than how I did it, but I'm just trying to show y'all how to do it. And you're left with this. So now what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to take this image and bring it into Photoshop. And then once the image is opened up in Photoshop, you're going to go over to Adjustments and then go over here to Hue and Saturation. And then where it says lightness, you're gonna want to turn that all the way down so that the image is just black. It's just black fire glasses now. And then you're going to want to save that and export it as a PNG. Open the fire glasses black in Photoshop. But then once you have the fire glasses open in Photoshop, you're going to want to go up here in the adjustments and invert it. That way it will make the fire glasses white. And then you can come over here to selective color and then make sure the colors is set to whites. And then you can just turn up any one of these that you want all the way so that the white image gets the color. And then once the color is placed onto the fire glasses, you can come over here to the hue and saturation. And then right here under hue, you are able to change the fire glasses to whatever color you want. So for this tutorial, I guess I'm going to make them blue. And now the fire glasses are blue, so you're just going to want to save that PNG. And now you can quit Photoshop for good because we don't need it anymore. And now you have your blue fire glasses. Now we are going to go into Lens Studio and open a new project. And then you're going to want to drag the blue fire glasses into Lens Studio, into the resources panel. Also, sorry if you hear my computer, it's just being loud. You're going to want to go up to the objects panel and then click on it and go to face effects and then go to face image. And then you're going to drag the blue fire glasses into the texture in the inspector panel. And they're gonna look small at first, but you can just drag them from the corners and it will increase the size. And you can do this however small or big you want the glasses. I'm just gonna make them this big for now. And always make sure you have the glasses put down a little bit because you want it to look real on the Snapchat filter. And then you can mess around with the blend mode. There's many blend modes that you can use for the glasses. Some of the ones I like are Lighten, Screen, Vivid Light, Color, Overlay, Hard Reflect, and the Realistic. But the blend mode I have for my Fire Glasses filter is in Color, like this. So then you can go in and add whatever post effects you want. So I always add face retouch. And then you can go in and add the name that you want, and then you can add the icon, and then whatever preview you want, and then make sure you apply all of that, and then you can go to Publish Lens, and you can publish it for all your friends to use. But yeah, that is basically the whole Fire Glasses filter complete. Comment down below if you want me to make a tap to change tutorial, because I do have a few tap to change lenses, like my Ubu filters tap to change, and also this Fire Glasses filter. So comment down below if you would want that. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also click the bell so you get notified every time I post a brand new video. And also don't forget to leave a like on this video and also comment down any video ideas or video requests that you would have, because I'm always checking the comments. If this tutorial helps you and you make any filters using this tutorial or any of my other tutorials, don't forget to comment down below the link to the lens that you make so that myself and others can use it. And also don't forget to follow me on all my social media, my Instagram, Snapchat, and TikTok. And also don't forget to use all my Snapchat lenses. You can search up my name, Christian Roberts, on Snapchat and they will all pop up. And also don't forget to use my filters on Instagram. You can just go to my Instagram, click the little filter icon on my account, and then they will all pop up. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye guys.